Raconteurs and Spoken Realms present Devi Mahatmyam, The Glory of the Goddess, by Sage Markandeya. Translated by Lyndall Verco. Read by Tim Bruce, with original music composed and performed by Tim Bruce. When this story is told, then both those who sing it and those who listen with devotion, to them no trouble shall come, nor any calamities from wrongdoing, nor poverty, nor separation from loved ones. They shall not experience fear from enemies, from robbers or rulers, from fire or flood or any weapon. Therefore this poem of my majesty must be recited and listened to with full attention and sincere devotion, for it is the supreme source of blessings.
Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Mahakali Sakshat Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai Namo Namaha.
Chapter 1. That noble king, Surata, had ruled over his prosperous land like a benevolent father until a conspiracy of jealous kings had attacked his kingdom and reduced it to a single city. Even there, he had been undermined by treacherous ministers. He had escaped assassination, pretending he was going hunting. He had ridden away into the forest wilderness, until he found refuge in this peaceful ashram of the Rishi Medas. King Surata was so full of grief, he could not rest. One day, as he wandered, unseeing among the gardens and trees, he discovered another man sitting by the path. This richly dressed man looked despondent. The king asked the stranger tenderly, "Who are you, sir? I feel that you have a heavy heart. What brings you here to this quiet place?" The merchant stood up. He bowed and thanked the king for his kind attention as he introduced himself. His name was Samadhi. They sat together and told each other of their losses. The merchant had been cruelly thrown out of his own home by a disloyal wife and greedy sons. "But, O king, I cannot stop worrying about their welfare. I love them all, and fear for their souls that they should have acted so wickedly." The king's voice was gentle and soothing. "It seems strange, don't you feel, that you grieve and worry for these people when they have been so unfeeling towards you?" The merchant responded, "O king, even as you were speaking, the same thought occurred to me. I wonder what binds us so deeply to our fates when we are helpless to alter these situations." "Since our fates have brought us here," the king said, "let us seek the advice of the great Rishi Medas on the matter." They rose together, and with purposeful steps they approached the Rishi's dwelling place. The king and the merchant each bowed respectfully to touch the feet of the ancient sage, Midas. He gestured invitingly. When they were seated, his kind eyes looked inquiringly, and the king spoke for both of them, saying,
"Beloved teacher, I just want to know one thing. This problem obsesses my mind, but my intellect cannot resolve it. I am still obsessed about..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.